Okay, let's do this. Hi guys, and welcome back to Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc. In the last episode, we did some investigation. Only half an hour, which was a pretty short investigation, but we'll take it. In today's episode, we are going to be starting the trial, as we usually do. And yeah, let's just jump right into it. I believe this is the one that has the separate ending. I don't know whether I want to go for that or not. I probably will. Whoa, Byakuya and Makoto showed up together. Where the heck have you two been? You just disappeared without a word. We were investigating, of course. How could you not figure that out by this point? Makoto's ranked high enough for you guys to go off together. Just the two of you. What? Are you jealous?
Or are you making up some kind of creepy fantasy for yourself?
What?
Stop talking and brace yourselves. He'll be here any second. Any second. He could show up at any time. When I imagined what was about to happen, I immediately tensed up and prepared myself. But we stood there for 5 full minutes, waiting for something weird to happen. And then 5 minutes became 10. What's going on here? Why hasn't Monokuma shown up yet? Maybe he died again.
What should we do? Should we keep waiting here, or...
or what?
Jesus!
Did I scare you?
I demand an explanation. Why did you waste my time and make me wait like that?
What? I made you wait? You've got it all backwards. You're the ones making me wait.
Huh?
I'm waiting for everyone to arrive. We can't start till everyone's here now, can we?
What are you talking about? Everyone is here. We've all been waiting for you.
Sorry, but you got that wrong. Sorry what you got, yo. Sorry, Maggie. Stole your pun.
But I've been waiting 10 minutes. But I've been waiting 10 minutes now, so it's okay if I punish the one making us all wait, right?
If we all agree it's a violation, I'll arrange a punishment right now.
If it's me you're waiting for, I'm here. When we heard that voice, we all spun around to look. Hey. I'm here, and no rules being broken.
Kyoko!
Kyoko, you're still alive?
No, that's a ghost!
Stop talking.
If you want to fight, do it at the class trial. You need to save some of the fun for later, right?
But is it okay that there's no particular penalty for being late?
I made it here just fine. What school regulation did I violate? Am I wrong? You're so selfish. So spoiled. You're right. There's no penalty, officially. But I bet you'll be sorry later. No, I'll make sure you're sorry later. Anyway, hustle your butts onto the elevator. I'll be just one step ahead of ya.
When Monokuma was gone, we all rushed up to Kyoko.
Kyoko! So you really didn't die?
Of course I didn't die.
Thank God. I'm so glad you're okay.
Perhaps, but that's not necessarily a good thing for us.
Huh?
He's right, now we've got to deal with a ghost!
I told you, stop talking.
Let's go.
Come on, let's just go. Whatever we need to discuss, we can do it during the trial.
Without ever looking directly at Kyoko, Byakuya stepped into the elevator.
Master, wait for me.
Good call. Who knows what might happen to us if we take too long.
I'll be happy when this trial is all over.
One after another, everyone piled into the elevator. But I couldn't help myself. I had to talk to Kyoko before the trial started. Listen, before we get started, I have to ask you. Where have you been this whole time? You used that key of yours to go somewhere, didn't you? So... I went to investigate the second floor of the dorms.
The second floor?
There aren't many monitors or cameras there, so I was able to avoid Monokuma completely. Of course, I also missed his announcement because of that. I had no idea a body had been discovered. Then, when did you find out?
Just now, I finished my search and came back down, just in time to hear the class trial announcement.
I took some time to go over the crime scene first. I can't go to a trial completely uninformed, can I? So that's why you were late. I'm sorry I kept you all waiting. But if you were on the second floor of the dorms, then that's what the key you found goes to?
Actually, to be precise, not quite. I used Monokuma's secret tool, which can open any lock in the school.
What?
Ooh, dang.
Hey, what are you two doing? Hurry up before you get in trouble with Monokuma!
We can go over all the details after we get through the trial. Okay, Makoto? Right now, I just want to focus on surviving our current situation. Because this is probably the single most crucial moment so far for me.
For her?
That's a strange way to put it. The class trial is important for everyone, right? So why would she say it's a crucial moment for her?
Goodbye.
Well, if that's all. Seemingly unconcerned, Kyoko made her way to the elevator. I'm just overthinking what she said, right? Being the last one left, I stepped into the elevator. And the doors slid shut. This time, the clanking was loud enough to hurt my ears, and the dread began to consume me once again. I can't imagine ever getting used to the mental pressure that comes with preparing for an execution. God, these episodes really do a number on my throat. Oh god, it hurts. Thankfully, it's a trial, so I don't have to talk too much after this. In that dusky darkness, nobody said a word. We just stood there, silent and still. After an immeasurable period of time, the doors opened without any warning. A dazzling light penetrated every depth of my eyes. But it wasn't the illuminating light of hope. It was the blinding light of despair.
I've been waiting for this. It feels like it's been forever since we got together like this. This time for pointless jokes and jabs has passed.
Oh, the time.
Let's get on with the show!
So, the curtain opened for the fifth time. A deadly judgment, a deadly deception, a deadly betrayal. A deadly riddle, a deadly defense, a deadly faith. A deadly class trial. We will save it right here. And we're gonna set some skills. We've got extraordinary focus. Increases the focus gauge by 2. Effective during class trial. Oh, what? I can't equip it. Yeah, so how much SP does it take? It costs 2 SP, so I should be able to equip it, right? Game? Gimlek, please. Oh, that's why. Extraordinary focus is... Menacing focus is like the better version of extraordinary focus. Okay, I got it. This increases by 2, this increases by 5. Got it. I'm smart. I think. Probably not. Let's just get right into it.
Let's begin with a basic explanation. If you
keep... Blah, blah, blah.
Discuss the specifics of the victim. First, we need to clarify who exactly the unidentified victim is.
It's Kyoko. There's no other explanation.
But Kyoko's standing right there.
No! That's a ghost!
But she has legs and stuff.
Well, that's just because she's like the latest evolution in ghost technology.
His idiocy knows no bounds.
Ridiculousness I can tolerate.
Okay. So I just have to prove that the corpse isn't Kyoko, right? Then let's compare Kyoko's traits to the traits of the dead body.
Her traits?
One important trait that Kyoko has that proves the body doesn't belong to her? The gloves, right?
I got it! I'm talking about her gloves. They'll give us some insight into the mystery. I'm sure of it.
In that case, I think it would be helpful if someone explained why she actually wears those gloves.
And would you happen to know the answer?
In fact, Monokuma told me. Apparently, you have scars on your hands you don't want anyone to see.
Oh, you know, now that I think about it, the corpse wasn't wearing any gloves, right?
They probably just got burnt up in the explosion. I'm not convinced. The ghost has just tried to fool us all.
There's no way that corpse was Kyoko. But if I can't prove it, why But if I can't prove why, we're gonna be stuck here and the case won't move forward. So I don't have any choice but to... make an argument. Okay, I need to like... Yes, okay. Every class trial, I forget the controls. For non-stop debates, and all of it, basically. Okay, so the silencer is right mouse button. Aim and shoot is left. Fast forward is control. Space is concentrate, so slow down. The mouse wheel selects a truth bullet. Left mouse button. Holding the left mouse button. We'll fire the truth bullet or hook a flashback. F1, blah blah blah. Okay, we should be good. That Kyoko there is just a ghost.
Okay, then prove it. Prove she's not a ghost.
The dead body wasn't wearing
gloves. They got burnt up in the explosion.
So it's either the fake nails or tattoo on right hand, right?
This entire discussion is...
we're gonna go with the tattoo. I know that body is in Kyoko's, and I know I can prove it.
That Kyoko there?
Impossible.
Okay, then prove it.
The dead body wasn't wearing gloves.
They got burnt up in the explosion.
Then she was wearing gloves before the explosion?
Well, yeah, she must have been wearing gloves. Because that corpse is...
Are you serious?
This entire discussion is idiotic.
Oh my gosh, I can't do this. No, shit. That's bad.
Shoot.
She wasn't wearing gloves.
There is just a ghost.
Oh, explore body analysis, right?
Okay, then prove it.
Prove she's...
The dead body wasn't wearing gloves.
They got burnt up.
Then she was wearing gloves.
Well, yeah, she must have been wearing gloves.
No, really? I am so confused by this.
That Kyoko there is just a Okay, then prove it.
The dead body wasn't wearing gloves.
I'm gonna hopefully use this. I think it might be this.
Well, yeah, she must have been wearing gloves.
No? Screw it, let's do fake nails.
Impossible.
Okay, then prove
the dead body what
they got burnt up.
Then she was wearing gloves before the explosion.
Well, yeah, she must have been wearing
gloves. There we go. Really? It was just that? Like, really? Like, really, really?
No, there's no way the corpse was wearing gloves. Whoever it was, they were wearing fake nails, remember? I imagine trying to wear gloves over nails like that would have been a pretty...
That makes so much sense.
Besides, Kyoko wears gloves to hide her hands, right? It'd be pretty weird for someone who's self-conscious about their hands to wear fake nails, don't you think?
That's also a really valid point.
You don't know women, huh? They're complicated like that.
If anyone doesn't know women, it's you.
Well, Kyoko, any thoughts?
These gloves were custom made to the size of my hands to make sure they don't interfere with my daily life. If I wore fake nails, the gloves wouldn't fit properly.
Then that's that. The dead body doesn't belong to Kyoko.
Which should have been obvious since she's standing right here.
Okay, so then, who's the real victim? First, we need to figure that out.
That's the first thing I said. You're the one who's been dragging us around in circles.
Before anything, we have to identify the victim. Everything starts from there. Is it Hangman's Gambit? No? Oh.
Sprinkler's explosive. Tattoo on right hand, probably.
If Kyoko really is still alive, then who died?
There's gotta be some way to. I don't think so. The face was scorched beyond recognition.
Oh, shit. The face was scorched me.
If Kyoko really. Then who died?
There's gotta be. I don't think so.
The face. And there wasn't any description in the Monokuma file.
We can't identify the body.
Shit. No. No!
Do, right?
If Kyoko really.
Then who died?
It's gotta be.
I don't think so. The face was scorched beyond recognition, and there wasn't any description in the Monokuma file.
Well, if we can't identify the body.
Then there's nothing else we can do.
Really?
Right?
Really? It's. Really?
If Kyoko really.
I'm being an idiot, though. All I need to do is this. Like, really. Just use the focus. Just gotta focus.
There were two behind that we can use to identify the body.
What? For real?
If you're lying, you'll die a cruel and unusual death.
A cruel and unusual death? This I gotta see.
She's just being stupid. Ignore them, Makoto. Tell us what you're talking about.
The key to figuring out who it was is the tattoo on the back of her hand.
Oh, yeah. The design's pretty strange, huh? Is this a dog?
Her master must have made her get it to be like, you're my bitch.
Seriously? They really did something that humiliating?
No, that's not it. The identity of the victim is hidden within that tattoo.
Oh, really?
If you compare the tattoo to other information we have, the victim's identity should become clear. This. Blah 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 blah. Yeah, it's this. Hey, we got half a heart back.
That's the name of the military group Mukuro Ikusaba belonged to.
Okay, so.
To show that they're a member of the team, each soldier that joins the squad would get a tattoo representing Fenrir somewhere on their body.
Fenrir?
The image that represents Fenrir is. Oh, this is Hangman's Gambit now. Wolf, right? Yeah, whoa, I need an L and an F. Bam.
Now I understand.
Now I understand.
The representation of Fenrir is a wolf.
Fenrir, the wolf of Ragnarok. It's from Norse mythology. A huge world-ending wolf beast.
He's the child of the trickster god Loki, and a female giant.
Man, after all this time, we finally got a glimpse of the literary all-star.
A wolf tattoo. Then that means...
Exactly. The body we found had a tattoo of a wolf, which means that person must have once belonged to Fenrir. So it must have been Mukuro.
What?
Hold on. Isn't she the one that was behind this whole thing?
You sound surprised, but you're absolutely right. Yes, indeed. The trial this time is to solve the murder of Mukuro Ikusaba.
Are you saying the mastermind is dead? And now we have to have a cool-ass trial?
No. It means we were wrong in thinking that Mukuro was the mastermind at all.
But I mean... Being the ultimate despair seems like a pretty mastermindy title to me.
Maybe we shouldn't have been thinking of her as the ultimate despair in the first place. After all, looking at her profile, I didn't see anything that would fit such a description. All it said was that she was the ultimate soldier. If I remember correctly, that other information came from Kyoko. That's what you told Makoto, right?
So that means Kyoko got it wrong?
she's been gone this whole time? And when she finally turns up, she gets killed.
Usually when there's a scene where an important character dies, it has a lot more detail.
So you're saying she wasn't an important character? Which would mean she was the same as us. Just another participant.
Then, who's the real mastermind?
It must have been the Hope's Peak Academy headmaster after all.
No, the headmaster has nothing to do with it.
But how can we trust that? We already know your information about Mukuro was wrong.
My information was not wrong.
Okay, okay! We're in the middle of a trial right now. Figuring out who killed Mukuro is first and foremost! Please limit all future prattle, chatter, and chit-chat as much as possible!
Fine. Uncovering the identity of the mastermind will have to wait. But remember this. No matter what happens, we will find out who you really are. I stake my family name on it.
I have officially decided to completely ignore all such attempts at provocation. Now then, just so nobody's confused, let me state this one more time for the record. The reason we're having a class trial is because a murder among the students has taken place. Hammer that point straight into your big old brains!
What you're saying is that both the victim and the culprit are part of the student body?
Then, one of us killed Mukuro?
Wait, no! There's a chance that there's some mystery 17th person who's been hiding all along!
Nope! There are only 16 students in total that have been taking part in these events!
Seriously? Then, one of us killed Mukuro?
Who did it? Who's the killer this time?
Get a hold of yourself. We've already narrowed down the list of possible suspects.
Huh?
I'm sure you realize who I'm talking about, right, Makoto? Who the evidence points to?
Based on what we know, there can only be two suspects. Myself and Kyoko.
You've narrowed it down to Kyoko and me, right?
Why do you say that?
Allow me to explain. Just after nighttime last night, I went to the garden. So I can confirm that at that point, there was no dead body there. So, the murder must have taken place after I left the garden. However, Hiro, Toko, Hina, and I were in the gym the entire time.
The gym?
That's right. The four of us were there trying to dismantle Monokuma. The whole time, we were very careful not to go anywhere alone. We even went to the bathroom in pairs. All of which is to say, the four of us all have alibis. The only ones without alibis
are me and Makoto. That's why you're able to narrow down the list of suspects.
Exactly so.
So the only suspects now, I mean, Kyoko. Damn it. I can't let this stand. Somehow I have to clear my name.
I have something I'd like to say regarding the whole alibi thing.
Are you thinking of raising an objection?
Well, before that, I just want to try and get a better idea of what time the murder took place. Doing that might reveal some kind of clue.
Whatever you want, somebody go ahead and help him out.
Me and Byakuya can both confirm that the body wasn't in the garden at... Well, it was after nighttime for sure. I'd say it must have been around 10 o'clock. So the murder must have happened after 10 p.m.
Then I guess we can say the time frame for the murder was between then and when we found the body? Oh, but what time did we find the body?
The one who saw the body first was Toko, right? And she went to go get the pickaxe.
So what time was the body discovered? 9 o'clock.
I got it! The body must have been discovered at 9 a.m., since that's when Toko went to get the pickaxe.
Now then, Toko, what time is it? Yeah. Blah, blah, blah.
He's right. It had to be around then.
So we can be totally sure the murder happened sometime between 10 at night and 9 in the morning.
For me, I was already asleep before nighttime hit. So I don't have an alibi after 10 o'clock. But I'm sure I met up with everyone else before 9 this morning.
We ran into each other in the dining hall, right? That was around... Oh, yeah! Right around 7:30. I remember checking right before I went in, so I'm totally sure about it.
Which means from 10 p.m. to 7:30 a.m., you don't have an alibi.
The murder happened between 10 p.m. and 9 a.m, and I don't have an alibi from 10 p.m. till 7:30 a.m. Okay, then it looks like the game has begun. If I can't provide an alibi for that period, then I just have to prove the murder didn't happen during the time I don't have an alibi. Sprinklers!
We've established a time frame for the murder. It took place somewhere between 10 o'clock at night and 9 o'clock in the morning.
Okay.
Yep, and Makoto doesn't have an alibi for most...
Yeah, from 10 to 7:30.
That's more than enough time to commit murder, I should think. So Makoto, if you have any objections, now would be the time.
I think it's Asahina's quote. Nope. Okay. Then I think it's Byakuya's. Come on, Makoto. Don't scare me like that. Makes me think something weird is going on.
We've established a time frame for the murder. It took place somewhere between 10 o'clock.
Yeah. Okay. My original assumption was right, but I thought Asahina's made more sense. Clearly not. Clearly it didn't.
Actually, the murder couldn't have happened anywhere near 10 o'clock. It had to have taken place way later.
And what makes you say that?
Because of the sprinklers in the garden. The sprinklers are set to go off right at 7:30 every morning, right? So if the body had been in the garden before 7:30, then it should have been completely soaked.
Oh, hold on! I remember this part perfectly! The body was wet. Dripping wet, in fact.
Sorry, Toko, but you're wrong.
I'm wrong? How? Are you saying only the mouth down south was wet? How dare you spew such indecent words?
No, I'm saying that the body was wet, but not because of the sprinklers.
What do you mean? By denying the sprinkler, are you trying to deny my entire existence?
Man, you're totally wacko.
If you really think it wasn't the sprinkler, you'd better tell us why!
I need to prove that wasn't the sprinklers that got the body wet. All I have to do is hit Toko with certain evidence, and that should do it. Oh, it's another, bolt action. God, I don't remember the controls for this. Lock-on is right, so right, and then left is obviously hit. Reload is tab. Selecting the truth bullet is Q. Activating speed, fever time is space. Okay. Why does it seem like I have infinite ammo?
Are you trying to blame me? I admit nothing. I'm right about this. I admit nothing. No, no, no! That's enough! Are you trying to blame me? I admit nothing. No, no, no! That's enough! Are you trying to blame me?
Shit.
I hate you.
Wait, oh, we're doing this again.
Hold on. Are you trying to blame me? I admit nothing.
So, there was that, right? I'm on such low health. Oh boy, this is bad.
Just remember what the body was like after the explosion, and you'll see why it wasn't the sprinklers. The top half of the body was wet, yes, but the bottom half was completely dry. If the sprinklers got the body wet, shouldn't...
So they only got the top wet?
Sorry about that, Skip.
Completely dry? What a brutal maniac!
I'm so sick of her.
Let's just
move on. The reason only the top half was wet was because... while the body was still on fire, I doused it with water. But only the part on fire, the top half.
Oh, then I guess the sprinklers really didn't do it.
So if the sprinklers didn't get the body wet, then the murder must have taken place sometime after the sprinklers turned on at 7:30 in the morning.
Which means she must have been killed sometime between then and when the body was discovered at 9.
But Makoto's alibi was only missing from 10 o'clock last night to 7:30 this morning, right?
So there's no way Makoto could have done it. I guess you had an alibi after all. Good for you.
In which case, the only one left without an alibi is Kyoko.
Kyoko is the only one without an alibi, which would mean that Mukuro's killer is... No, I refuse to believe it. Kyoko murdered someone? That's...
I'd just like to say one thing. If you vote for me and I die here, the mystery of this school will stay hidden forever. Which is why I can't let that happen.
Huh?
So are you saying you're not the culprit?
Of course I'm not. I have no reason to kill anyone. This is a trap the mastermind has laid for us.
A trap?
We're this far into the game and now you decide to blame me? Stop wasting time! Stop wasting energy! You really think your little trick is gonna work?
Shut up, you!
You got it, boss! Shutting up now!
Anyway, Kyoko, you actually did have a reason to kill her.
Huh? She did?
She thought Mukuro was the ultimate despair. In other words, the mastermind behind everything. So she killed her to try and put a stop to all this. Isn't that right, Kyoko? But you made one catastrophic mistake. Mukuro wasn't the mastermind at all. And as a result, we were forced into another trial. Something I'm sure you weren't at all expecting.
So that was her motive?
If she had a motive and no alibi, well then... I think it's pretty clear Kyoko's gotta be the culprit.
I'm not the only one without an alibi. Makoto's explanation is still insufficient.
Huh?
The sprinklers didn't get the body wet, but that doesn't mean the murder happened when he said it did.
What are you...
Because you see, there is a way the body could have avoided getting wet.
Interesting. I'm listening.
All it would take is covering the body with a certain something to keep it from getting wet.
A certain something at the scene we used to cover the body? Could it have been... I don't know exactly where the other ending is, so I'm gonna have to try and play it by memory? Memory? No. I don't know. I'm confused. I know there's something I've got to call out at some point, but...
All you'd have to do is cover the body with the tarp, and that'd take care of the water. In fact, that's exactly what the killer did. The dirt pattern on the tarp can attest to that. Only one side of the tarp got dirty, because that's the side that got covered in water. The side that faced down over the body, meanwhile, kept perfectly clean. This proves that the killer used the tarp to keep the body from getting soaked.
But why would they go to all that effort just to keep the body from getting wet?
Most likely so they could cloud the issue of when the murder actually took place. In other words, to create an excuse exactly like the one Makoto just gave us.
Why would Kyoko say that? Why would she want to make me look like the killer? No, I can't think about that right now. That tarp. If it was used the way Kyoko said, the tarp must have touched the body, right? But the body...
Wait, something's not right.
And what might that be?
I can't worry about Kyoko's motivations. If I don't do something, everyone's gonna think I'm the killer. I have to refute what Kyoko said. Argument. Knife. Body before the explosion. I think it's when the body was found.
By covering the body with the tarp, the
sprinkler got that side wet.
But the underside of the tarp, it was totally spotless, right?
It's because that side was protected from the water.
Shit.
Shoot.
Oh, this is bad.
By covering the body, killer prevents.
So the reason the tarp was because the sprinkler.
But the underside, it was totally.
It's because that side was. Since it was facing down toward the body, of course it didn't get dirty.
Really? Oh shit. Another game over, yay! Oh no. Clearly we're going again. Okay, we've got our health back. That's important. I should probably go through these pieces of evidence first. So it's all about the body. Yep, the half of the body remained on fire and had to be extinguished. No, it's not that. When the body was found. Blah blah blah. Okay. The body had stopped bleeding, but the blood was still wet. Ah, I think I got it. So it is correct. Maybe I don't got it.
By covering the body with the tarp, the killer prevented it from getting wet.
So the reason the tarp was only dirty on one side is because the sprinkler got that side wet.
But the underside of the tarp, it was totally spotless, right?
It's because that side was protected from the water. Since it was facing down toward the body, of course it didn't get dirty.
Wait. There has to be a clue hidden in the top somewhere. One side was wet and filthy, the other side was completely clean and dry. I'm still so confused by this. Like, incredibly confused. Oh, I'm so confused. I'm actually really confused by this.
The killer prevented it from getting wet.
So the reason the tarp was only dirty on one side is because the sprinkler got that side wet.
But the underside of the tarp.
Let's just get
totally
time.
Spotless, right?
It's because that side was protected from the water. Since it was facing down toward the body, of course it didn't get dirty.
I'm so confused.
By covering the body with the tarp, the killer prevented it from getting wet.
So the reason the tarp was only dirty on us
sprinkler got... But the underside of the tarp, it was totally spotlit. It's because that side was protected since it was facing down.
Of course it didn't get dirty!
Oh my gosh, I am so damn confused.
By covering the body with the tarp, the killer prevented it from getting wet.
So the reason the tarp was only dirty on one side is because the sprinkler got that side wet.
But the underside, it was totally spot.
It's because that side was protected from the water.
I'm debating looking this up. Yeah, no, I gotta search this up. Web browser, let's go. Havoc Trial 5. What would be a great term to search? No. Refuting kitty kitty. I mean, I guess this. Okay. Investigation. We got the trial. Kato on right hand, blah blah blah, wolf, using Kato and Kyoko, 9 o'clock, sprinklers. Didn't get dirty? Body before the explosion. Okay, so it should be, I didn't read any further, but body before the explosion.
So the reason the tarp is because the sprinkler got that side,
but the underside, it was totally
sp- it's because that side was pretty, since it was facing, of course it didn't get dirty.
I am so confused about why this is right. Sorry.
Actually, one side being clean is pretty strange if you think about it. Because the blood wasn't dry before the
I mean, yeah, that's what I was going for, but that was so confusing.
Byakuya said it himself. Not to touch it, or you might get some on you. If you put a tarp on a body in that state, it absolutely would have gotten blood on it.
Well, maybe the culprit washed it, so nobody would know they'd used it.
If they had, they would have washed both sides. Just washing the one side wouldn't hide anything.
Yeah, true.
More than that, what if the very blood we saw on the body was meant as a kind of camouflage?
Huh? The blood was camouflage?
What if, after the killer used the tarp to avoid the sprinklers, they then covered the body in blood that didn't belong to the victim?
You mean someone else's blood? Where would they get something like that?
I know! They could have grabbed some of the blood packs from the nurse's office. That's what Hifumi did, right? When he pretended to be dead?
No, that's not what happened this time. The killer got the blood from right there in the garden.
No! No! Oh, no! No, poor chicken, no! No! Chicken number 5!
When I checked the chicken coop before the murder, there were 5
chickens. Chicken number 5, why? Why'd you have to die so young?
But after the murder, there were only 4.
So, you're saying...
We will remember you forever and always.
And then cover the body with its blood? Man,
messed up.
Killing a living thing just to do something like that is awful. They should have at least eaten it.
I wonder if the killer had to get the blood from the scene so they wouldn't be spotted walking around. Anyway, there's no denying that a chicken went missing, which provides a basis for my theory.
Perhaps, but even so, there's one thing that still doesn't make sense. You said the culprit used the tarp to avoid the water and then covered the body in blood, right? But if that's the case, then the blood should have soaked into the ground around the body. But that's not what we saw. Only the victim's clothing had blood on it. The ground was completely clean.
I have to agree, that certainly is strange. Maybe they didn't apply the blood at the scene. Maybe they covered the coat in blood beforehand.
They covered it beforehand?
When you discovered the body, was it wearing the coat like you normally would?
I think so. Wait, no. The head was through the neck hole, but the arms weren't in the sleeves.
Oh, I didn't even notice that.
Then that settles it.
Sorry, I'm having a tough time keeping up.
Here's what happened. The murder took place before the sprinklers went off. But the body didn't get wet, because the killer covered it with the tarp. Then, later, at the same time the killer was gathering up the tarp, they pulled the coat over the body. The coat they'd already covered in blood. This series of cover-ups was meant to disguise the actual time the murder occurred. They wanted us to think the murder happened sometime after the sprinklers had gone off, at 7:30.
If that's actually what took place, it certainly becomes possible that the murder happened earlier.
But to pull all that off, wouldn't they have had to go back to the garden after the sprinklers turned off?
That actually wouldn't have been all that difficult.
Huh?
They already had the coat ready, so they just had to grab the tarp and pull the coat over the body. They'd be done in no time.
Maybe, but still.
Hina, after you met up with Makoto in the dining hall, did you two stay together from that point on?
Oh, no. I headed off to the gym, and Makoto didn't show up till later.
Then he had plenty of time to spare, wouldn't you say?
That's not...
Don't bother saying it's not possible.
I must admit, Kyoko's reasoning is sound. Makoto's alibi is inadequate.
And the suspicion falls back on me again. But why? Why is Kyoko trying to entrap me? I don't understand.
Well then, it looks like we're back to square one. Makoto's alibi is no good, so once again, our suspects are him and Kyoko.
For serious, man? Which one of them did it? Hey, why don't we let luck decide? Let's flip a coin. 50-50 odds.
Oh!
See? Pretty good idea, right?
No, not that. I just remembered something super serious.
Well, don't just stand there. Out with it.
You know that knife we found all black and burnt?
The one we found stuck in the body before it exploded, right? According to the Monokuma file, the knife went all the way through, from front to back. So, what about it?
I'm pretty sure I'd seen that knife somewhere before. That's what I thought when I first saw it. I just remembered.
Listen, more important, now that we have the knife, what are we gonna do with it? We can't let Toko keep it, that's for sure. We don't know what she might do. I don't want it anyway. So what to do? Why don't you hang on to it, Makoto? Huh? Me?
It's the knife we gave to Makoto?
You don't seem surprised. You must have noticed earlier.
Yeah.
Then why did you hide that fact?
It's not that I hid it. It's just...
I couldn't be sure of what actually happened last night. I thought maybe I really did kill her.
Suspicious. Very suspicious indeed. The knife we found stuck in the body came from Makoto. Now I'm totally convinced he did it. 12,000% convinced.
Considering everything up until now, I should be able to make it clear. I have to prove that I didn't murder anyone. I'm not the killer. going. Let's just listen to it. Disguise body, fragments and when the body was found. Okay.
Makoto did it!
Just because I had the knife once? That automatically makes me the killer?
Well, getting stabbed is what killed her, right? So there's no question. You took that knife of yours and killed her with it.
No. I would have been here. If they were stabbed a single time, where it went through the body, Wait, is it that one of my truth bullets? Knife? Fragments, when the body found. It's disguised dead body. A single stab wound. If I dragged the coat over the body, then that knife, if that was the killing blow, that knife would have been put in twice because you wouldn't be able to drag the coat over the knife to make it look like it happened. So it's the disguised dead body. Yeah, I was right.
Wait, hold on. The stab wound isn't what killed Mukuro.
And this is where we end this part of the trial. Obviously, I'll be uploading the whole trial together, as I do with the other videos. But I think this is probably a good place to stop. We've been recording for 53 minutes. We're about halfway through, I'd say, now. We're a decent chunk through. In the next episode, I think we're getting close to the point where I make a decision for the ending, and I'm hopefully gonna get it, and it's hopefully gonna be good. So yeah, thank you all so much for watching this episode of Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc, and I don't know why I'm signing off when I'm literally recording right again after this. Meh! Bye!